Y'all can hear me? All right, cool. What's up, everybody? I have a pair of my shoes on right now, too, so I'm also a part-time model, if you already didn't know that. My name is, that was a great introduction, too, by the way. Thank you very much. Better than any intro that I could do for myself. I'm Omar Bailey, co-founder and chief creative officer of FCTRY Lab. It is a footwear innovation lab with a venture studio business model. But first, I would like to give you a little context in my background before I dive a little bit more into the company. So my humble beginnings, you know, my journey, the journey to 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So this is that to me as a child, obviously, on the left. And in the middle is the first shoe that I ever designed that was made. It was a basketball shoe prototype for New Balance. So proud moment when I had that done, and then that is me today. My journey began at 7 years old. I started drawing and sketching sneakers as a child. I know a really weird thing to do for a kid, right? But like my parents, from the Caribbean, new to the country, you know, and they did not want to buy me sneakers because, as you see in that Sports Illustrated article, there was a whole lot of violence around Air Jordans in the early 90s. This was sort of a new phenomenon of the sneaker craze, and it resulted in a lot of just really bad things that happened, and my parents refused to buy me those shoes. So as a result, I started sketching and drawing them, and as you see on the left, those are actually some of my sketches from the early 90s of sketching and drawing shoes all the time. I mean, it was pretty weird, right? But I loved doing it. And some of the brands that I've, you know, after going to college and, you know, I did a bunch of internships and used some of the brands that I had opportunity to work with and really get that taste, you know, for what that was like in terms of actually creating a real shoe and how the shoe industry and all that works. I was able to go to China and experience what the real, like how the sausage is made, if you will, when seeing a shoe being created from, you know, A to Z, the whole process, understanding supply chain, understanding relationships, the suppliers, and, you know, how the whole system works. So that was a really big and important moment for me in getting that first experience, which led to hundreds more, and I was able to expand and evolve in working in factories all over the world from India, where I lived for 3 years. As I mentioned, China, Taiwan, South America, South Korea, Mexico, and just, you know, shoes. I've been very fortunate enough for footwear to take me sort of all over the world. These are some of the celeb collaborations that I was able to do over the course of the years. I'm sure a lot of you guys recognize that guy in the middle, Mr. Jose Bautista, good buddy of mine, and was able to design a baseball cleat for him that he's wearing in the image. That is the actual shoe that he hit in his bat flip moment as well, or he was wearing in the bat flip moment. And you know, he was honored earlier this year for inducted in the Blue Jays Hall of Fame. And then some of the other people that I've worked with over the years too as well. And then I found myself at Yeezy. Very controversial in the news recently for a lot of obvious reasons. But nonetheless, it was an incredible opportunity 4 years ago when I got the call to be the head of the innovation lab at Yeezy. We scaled that business from sub 1 billion to over almost 3 billion in revenue in about a year, year and a half. Which was an incredible feat and something that we were able to do in innovating and developing shoes and prototypes domestically. I even moved to Wyoming when Kanye decided that he wanted to live in the middle of Wyoming. I had to go with him. And I was there in Cody, middle of nowhere. I mean, it was really interesting, right? Like, I mean, you know, it wasn't a whole lot of people that looked like me in Wyoming. In fact, a lot of people thought I was Kanye, right? Like, and I'm not joking, but nonetheless, it was an incredible experience for me, and you know, being able to take some of those learnings in terms of how to push, how to go into corners of my mind from a creative perspective to really be able to explore and try new and create new and innovative footwear products. So FCTRY Lab. FCTRY Lab is all of these things that I've mentioned that you see up here, but our superpower is we can create intellectual property, not just in the form of shoes, but also in the form of content, right? It's something that we can do by giving people a sneak peek inside of the creation process of footwear. And then, you know, one of the things that we were able to do is really prove that, like, there's a consumer base out there that really gives a shit about the things that we make and do. And part of that venture studio model is working with creators of all kinds, and them working with us, connecting them with our IP, and then using our machine that we've been able to prove by the products that we've been able to sell to sell products to their audience, helping us grow our audience, and in turn, converting those to subscribers and being able to predict some formula in terms of sales and what we're able to do as a company. And next, I have a little video that I want to show to you guys.
The hidden man behind the Yeezy Foam Runner could be going from Kanye's employee to his competition.
They never believed that I would really fly. I had to go demonstrate. I had to set them straight. They hate when you elevate. Elevate, elevate. They hate when you elevate. Elevate, elevate. Yeah. They hate when you elevate. Elevate, elevate. They hate when you elevate. Yeah. Yeah, I had to elevate.
What's up, everybody? I'm Seth Fowler, and today I'm taking a look at the FCTRY Lab Night Runner.
Look at the packaging. I would say, what is that, a coffin? Because they're over there killing it.
So what happens when part of that Yeezy team decides to go off and start their own company?
We originally started out as just like all people of color.
But the thing about FCTRY Lab is that they're not like other sneaker brands out there. They're not like a new Adidas or a new Nike or anything like that. They're actually a new way of creating sneakers. So essentially what FCTRY Lab is a jumping off point for innovators.
We're gonna go show y'all what it's looking like in here. You ain't never seen a black man with his own shoe factory. I'm currently with my brother right now, Omar Bailey. He has one of the greatest shoe companies known to man.
This shoe in particular, I think in the four colorways that it dropped in, the black, white, blue, and green, and as of right now, have completely sold out.
Do you slide on all your nights like this? Do you try on all your nights like this?
Omar Bailey, the former head of Yeezy's Innovation Lab, has created the next wave of foam footwear.
The sleek design on these and the curvature around the entire shoe makes these so futuristic.
And thank you. And one thing to add is we didn't pay a single dime for any of that up there. That was all organic UGC that was created by fans, followers, influencers that we see to choose to, which shows the impact of our products and what it all means. So yeah, I'm Omar Bailey, and I'm just a kid that still draws sneakers. I want to take a selfie with everybody real quick. Show a little bit of energy. Hold on. Hey! One more. Hold on. Wait, that was blurry. All right, that works. Thank y'all.